अन्धे वांछित लाभाय कर्म किम तन्न कथ्यते किम दंपति मिति ब्रूयाम उताहो दंपति इति सो वी आर लुकिंग एट दुर्वासास दर्शनम राइट दुर्वासम नाम तापसम अद्राक्षीत वी आर डूइंग दैट गद्य पोर्शन गच्छन्नेव सनवसि भसित अवकुंठित सर्वांग संग लब्ध परभाग भासुराभिः अभिव्याप्य हृदयम अधिकतया बहिर्निर्गश निर्गमिष्यतः कोपानलस्य ज्वालाभिः इव पाटलाभिः जटाभिः अभिभवन्तम् इव तटित्वन्तम् अभिनवं शारद अम्बोधम् ऐ थिंक वी फिनिश्ड विद दैट वन मोर थिंग वी डिड राइट अपि च त्रिभुवन मुनिलोक वैलक्षण्य द शापम दैट ही गिव्स इज वेरी डिफरेंट from the others because he has the kirti or the fame of taking half of the energy from the others. If someone gives a shapam to him, for him it just comes, it does not affect him at all. So that is one of the different things that Durvasa has. That is why his shapam is vilakshana. Tribhuvana muni loka vailakshanya bodhinyaha शापमूल तपोलाभ संभव शापमूल तपोलाभ ही गेट्स द तपस एंड हिज तपस इंक्रीसेस द एफेक्ट ऑफ हिज तपस इंक्रीसेस बिकॉज ऑफ द शापम ऑल्सो दैट इज अनदर वे दैट पीपल सी राइट नाउ द नेक्स्ट डेफिनेशन द नेक्स्ट डिस्क्रिप्शन इज अबाउट द रुद्राक्ष माला दैट ही हैज कैन यू रीड दैट अति प्रचंड I think we have to start from there, right? Yeah.
Ati prachanda nijatopa anala jwala nija tapaha anala jwala kalapa pariplosham
no malinitaihi
pariplosha malinitaihi प्रतिशापाक्षरैर इव पारिंक
पारिकांक्षिकाणां
रुद्राक्ष मणि मणिभिः अभिवेष्टितं सोदर शशांक संदेशहारिकाभिः तारकाभिः इव तारकाभिरिव कर्णपुटाभ्यर्न लग्नाभिः स्फटिकाक्ष गुलिकाभिः अभिशोभितम्
विल स्टॉप विद दैट जस्ट द टू ऑफ दोज विल सी सो अति प्रचंड निज तपो अनल ज्वाला कलाप परिप्लोष सो हियर व्हाट ही इज ट्राइंग टू से इज अदर्स वी सॉ दैट त्रिभुवन मुनिलोक वैलक्षण्य शापमूल तपो लाभ दैट इज हिज स्पेशलिटी राइट because of the shapam his tapas increases now we saw that now what happens to the other sages who try to give him a shapa who try to curse him now what happens to them what happens is they all get destroyed in the sense they are made effectless in front of him right because they try to give a shapa then it has no effect in front of Durvasa so, looks at it as you know nij ati prachanda his anger that is Durvasa's anger in that anger flames the pratishapa akshara pratishapa is the shapam that the other people give in retaliation it is like a revenge no when Durvasa gives a shapa the other people also has to give another shapam if he is also an equally great sage so that pratishapa is the curse that the other person gives that pratishapa aksharaihi those words what happens to those words is they are completely destroyed in the flame the of Durvasa's tapas so ati prachanda great nija tapaha his own tapas penance that penance is equal to anala fire tapo anala that is rupaka alankara there metaphor he says tapas tapaha eva anala analaha agnihi तस्य अग्नेः ज्वालाः. सो दोज फ्लेम्स ऑफ द फायर दैट कूट द कलापः, कलाप इज द ग्रुप ऑफ द फ्लेम्स दैट कम आउट ऑफ हिज तपस, राइट. दैट व्हाट डज दोज व्हाट डू दोज फ्लेम्स डू, परिप्लोष, दे डिस्ट्रॉय द प्रतिशाप अक्षर. And because it has been destroyed by the Kopa Agni, those aksharas, the words of the Shapa, the curse that the other people give, those words, it's as if they have been rendered dirty, malinitam. What happens if an object is put into the fire, it becomes dirty, it burns and then it becomes like ash, it becomes very dirty, right? So it turns into a very dark color. That's what he says. So the Rudraksham that he wears, Rudraksha Manibihi Abhiveshtitam, it seems as if those Rudrakshas are like the Prati Shapa Akshara. But those Aksharas are not white, they are black in color. Why have they become black? It is as if they have been doused by the fire of his tapas. Ati Prachanda Nija Tapo Anala Jwala Kalapaihi. Kalapanam pariploshena. Pariploshaha is being doused by it, or you burn it with that agni. And because of that burning, those aksharas or the words that the other people say have become very dirty. Malinita aksharaihi eva rudraksha manibihi. It seems as if the rudraksha is a representation of the other people's the words that they use for cursing, for shapam. Okay, who are the other people? No, they are not normal people, they are parikankshikaha. Parikankshikanam pratishapa aksharehi. Whose aksharas are they? Parikankshika. Pari means brahmajnanam, that is param atra asti iti pari. Brahmajnanam, brahmajnanam kankshanti. They want that Brahmajnana, which means mumukshuhu, moksha iccha asti teshamiti mumukshuhu. It is not people who are Brahmajnana. That is, they are not tapasvi who have attained the realization, but they are only tapasvis who want to attain that, and they try to give the shapa, and those shapa akshara, the curse words, have become very, they are rendered effectless in front of his tapo agni. Okay, so ati prachanda nija tapo anala jwala kalapa pariplosha malinitaihi parikankshikanam pratishapa aksharaihi iva rudraksha manibihi. There, that pratishapa aksharaihi iva rudraksha manibihi is an utpreksha alankara. Rudraksha manibihi abhiveshtitam, he has those rudraksha mani on his neck or with his hand, it doesn't specify that. The next one is Sodara Shashanka Sandesha Harikabihi Tarakabihi Iva Karnaputa Abhyarnam Lagnabihi Spatikaksha Gulikabihi. He has crystal spatikam, spatikamala in his one minute. Why can't I put this down? This is so weird. Ah, yes, sorry. Spatikaksha gulikabihi abhishobitam. He, when we look at him, he also has a spatikakshamala on his ear. Karnaputa abhyarna, abhyarna samipam. So karnaputasya samipe lagnabihi, that which is attached to near his ear. That is, some people put that mala around their ear, right? It can hang on the ear. So that is what he has done. So spatika aksha gulika. Spatikaksha is spatikam mani. Gulika is mani, actually. So spatikaksha is spatikam. A mala or a garland made of spatika, he has it hung on his ear or near his ear. Now, what does it look like? It seems as if those patikas look like stars, taraka, taraka. What are these stars doing? It is as if the stars have taken, have brought some message from his brother, Shashanka, Chandra. Now, Atri and Anasuya are Durvasa's mother and father. They have also given birth to Chandra. There are Purana stories about how he was born and all that. He again mentions this part later, so I will say that story there also. So for now, Sodara Shashanka. Sodara Shashanka is the his own brother, Durvasa's brother Shashanka, the Chandra, has sent Sandesha. And through whom? Taraka. The star, it seems as if the stars have brought Harikabhi, they have brought the Sandesha message from his brother Shashanka Chandra, and they are near his ear in order to tell him that message. If you remember in Raghuvamsham, he talks about Jara coming near the ear. Jara is old age, right? And the first sign of old age is the hairs near the ear will start becoming white. So Dasharatha, as soon as he realizes that he is getting old, it seems as if the Jara or the old age has taken a form, comes near his ear and says, you know what, you're getting old. You have to give the kingdom to Rama. And the part that Kalidasa imagines there is, see, Jara is a feminine word, right? So he talks of her as if Kaikeyi might be jealous if another woman comes and talks to Dasharatha. So he says, Tam karna moolam agatya Rameshwarir nyasyatamiti. Tam karna moolam agatya. She comes near to his ear. Karna moolam agatya Rameshwarihi nyasyatamiti. Give the responsibility of the kingdom to Rama. Why does she say that? Kaikeyi shankaya iva aha palita chadmana jara. Kaikeyi shankaya. See, I should not come directly to you and say, because Kaikeyi is going to be very jealous. So let me come near your ear and say this. It's something like that. So when you want to convey a rahasya message, you always go near the ear and say it, right? Because you don't want anybody else. Here, Sodara, his brother, has sent some message to him. It is as if like that. So the Kavi is imagining that. Sodara Shashanka Sandesha Harikabihi Tarakabihi Iva. Those Patika Mala, the Patika money that is there, looks as if it is like Taraka, the stars, which have brought the message from his brother Shashanka. Sodara Shashanka Sandesha Harikabihi Tarakabihi Iva Karnaputa Abhyarna Lagnabihi Spatikaksha Gulikabihi Abhishobitam. Next. Agrihita?
Agrihitottara Uttara Sangam Angi Kruta Kaupina Matra Paridhanam Aspothayantam Upadam Anupadam Avarundhanta Madhvani Milanti Siddha Vadhu Kulani Trasayanta Miva Kataran Tajayanta Miva Shunasira Bhatanapi.
Let's stop with that. So Agrihita Uttarasangam. Uttara Asangam Agrihita. Uttara is Uttariyam, the top cloth. He is not wearing now. He goes to the description of his dress. So he has talked about what all he has. Mani, Rudraksha, Sphatika, all that he has. Next is, he comes to the top cloth. He doesn't have any top cloth, but he only wears a loin cloth. So Agrihita Uttara Asanga. Asanga is an attachment. Asanga is attachment. Uttara Asangam Agrihita. He has not taken up wearing of the upper cloth. Instead, Angi Krita, he has accepted wearing only Kaupina. Kaupina Matra Paridhanam. Paridhanam Vastra. Kaupinam Eva Vastram Tasya. So Kaupinam is loincloth. So he only wears a bottom cloth but not a top one. Aspotayantam Anupadam. At every step, it is as if there is a sound coming up. Aspotayantam means dhvani. Some sort of a sound is coming. It's like on cinema, no? when you have a big scene or a big character coming in, you'll know by the background music that is coming. Here, it is as if every step that he takes, there is a big sound that comes up. Aspotayantam Anupadam, at every step. Advani, in his path, Siddhavadhu Kulani Milanti Avarundhantam. Milanti, it is actually Milanti Siddhavadhu Kulani Shatraprityam, that is. So those Siddhavadhu, the Siddha women, Kula, the host of Siddha women who are gathering around Milanti, it is as if he is stopping them. Avarundhantam Advani. It is as if he is stopping those Siddha women in their path. See, when a personality like Durvasa is coming, people will want to round up and see him, right? There will be many ladies who will want to come and maybe do namaskaram to him or see him and all that. But as he is going, because of his tejas, people, it is as if he is stopping them in the midway and stopping them from gathering around him. Okay? So, Milan Siddhavadhu Kulani Advani Avarundhantam. Avarundhantam, who is stopping? This is all adjective to Durvasa again. Now, Katarana Trasayantam Iva. He is as if he is creating fear in people who are like cowards. And then Shunasira Bhatani Tarjayantam Iva. Shunasira is Indra. Indra Bhata, Indra's warriors. It is Tarjayantam. He is as if he is threatening them. Shunasira means Shunaha is Vayu and Sira is Surya. Vayu and Surya belong to Indra, or they are subordinates to Indra. So Shunasira means Indraha, Indrasya Bhataha, Sainikaha. So Shunasira Bhatanapi, even Indra's warriors are being threatened by him. Okay, next.
Gajjantamiva, Gayantamiva, Nrityantamiva, Swasvalantamiva,
Kalantamiva,
Valantamiva, Hasantamiva, Hridayaravinda, Kuhara Viharantam, Viharadun,
Unmatta Shekhara,
Bhavana Nair,
Nairantaryat,
Unmattamiva, Swayam, Apyavapta, Samasta Kamataya, Kinchidapya,
Nadrita,
Anadrita, Lokanta Tranu Vidhanam, Trilochanavataram.
Now, Garjantamiva, Gayantamiva, Nrityantamiva, Skhalantamiva, Hasantamiva, all these five adjectives are actually for a realized soul. See, a realized soul, Balon Mattava Deva, in Mohamudgara, you'll have this shloka. I just noted it down because it's a very beautiful one which explains the way Durvasa is also. Rathya Charpata Virachita Kantaha. We saw that, right? Agrihita Uttarasangam and Kaupina Matra Paridhanam. Rathya Charpata means, you know, the rags that you get in the road, he just wears a cloth with that. A yogi is such a person. Punya punya vivarjita pantaha. The path that he takes is neither attached to punya nor to apunya or papa. Yogi, because why? How can he be like that? Yoga niyojita chittaha. His mind is constantly in that yoga or samadhi avastha. So when he is in that samadhi avastha, bala unmattavate, he behaves as if he is an innocent child or like a crazy person. Like someone who has gone crazy. So it's very similar to that shloka where his behavior, Durvasa's behavior is very similar to that shloka, Garjantamiva. It's as if he is roaring like a lion, Gayantamiva. See, when your mind is filled with that God, the sense of Shiva in his mind, he explains in the next word where he says, Hrudaya Aravinda Kuhara Viharat Unmatta Shekhara Bhavana Nairantaryat. Unmattamira. He's as if he is crazy because there is this incessant in Nairantaryam, incessant Bhavana, that flow of thought of Shiva. Unmatta Shekharaha is actually Shiva. I don't know why it's called Unmatta Shekharaha. Unmatta is a type of flower. I forgot. See, the different flowers that he likes are Shweta Arka, Shweta Durva, Bilvam, Unmattakam, Shiva Priyani Chayetani, Drona Nilotpale Tatha. These are the flowers that he likes. So that Unmatta is another flower that he likes. So Unmatta Shekhara is Shiva here. So Hridaya Aravinda Kuhara, Hridaya Aravinda. I told you before, right, that the Harakasha that is there in the Hridayam, in the heart, it is in the form of a lotus. That's why Hridaya Aravinda is that the Harakasha that we talk about. So Hridaya Aravinda Kuhara, in the it's like a cave sort of thing. Inside that, Viharata, who is constantly there in Durvasa's mind like that, it is Unmatha Shekhara Shiva. And that Shiva's bhavana, the thoughts that are there, it is like a dharavahika. It's constantly flowing in his mind. That is nairantaryam. Antaram nasti. There is no obstacle or there is no stop there. Okay, let me wait. Let Shiva wait for some time. Let me put some other thought inside. No, that sort of a thing never happens. Constantly that thought is there in his mind. Maybe his outward appearances, he may be doing so many different things. Right? But inside his mind, he is always thinking about Shiva. Unmatta Shekhara Bhavana Nairantaryat Unmattamiva Garjantamiva Gayantamiva. So that is, this line will explain the first five adjectives or the first five Utpreksha that he says. It's as if he is roaring, as if he is singing, as if he is dancing. Nrityantamiva Skalantamiva. He is skipping. Skalantam is not, see, in a normal usage, Skalantam means the tadiki vidardhu, that is you falling down. You slip and fall is called skalantam. Whereas here, going with the context, you should say it's like he's skipping and dancing. No? Nrityantamiva, skalantamiva, hasantamiva. He's just laughing for no reason. What is the reason that he gives? There is nothing there. So the reason for acting, so anybody who looks at him will think that he is mad. But why? Hridaya Aravinda Kuhara Viharatu Unmatta Shekhara Bhavana Nairantaryat. I feel he is only mentioning Appaya Dikshitar here because Appaya Dikshitar has written Shivarpana Stotrama Unmatta Panchashat. It's also called Unmatta Panchashat where he says Atmarpanastuti. Sorry. Atmarpanastuti. Correct. So Adla, it is also called Unmatta Panchashat where there is one. Unmatta Shekhara, I told you that Unmatta is a type of flower, right? There is a fruit that comes from that tree, which is called, in Tamil, it is called Umattanga. It promotes craziness. So you take that, you become mad. Appaya Dikshitar wanted to test whether he thinks about Shiva even in that state. So he takes, voluntarily, he takes that fruit and he becomes mad. And he tells his, before that, he tells his student, you know, if I say anything about Shiva, then write it down. If I say anything other than that, immediately give me this, you know, the antidote for it and make me come out of it. I mean, it means that I am not still in that state. So he takes it and he writes, he says 50 shlokas or something like that. And that is called Atmarpana Stuti. Where it was said when he was in that mad state, Unmatta state. I feel he's talking about Appaya Dikshita here. Hridaya Aravinda Kuhara Viharatu. And every shloka is about Radhar. Hridaya Aravinda Kuhara Viharatu. Unmatta Shekhara Bhavana. The Bhavana or the thought process or the Dhara of Shiva is constantly playing in his mind. Because of that, it is as if he is mad. Unmattam iva swayamapi avapta samasta kamataya. Now all of this talks about someone who is completely away from any of the lokatantram. Lokatantram is the traditions that people follow in this world, right? So anadrata lokatantra anuvidhanam. He does not need to follow the customs and traditions that are there in the world. Why? Because avapta samasta kamataya. Why do we adopt to the traditions in this world? See, if we follow what we have to do, then people will not laugh at us. If we do this, then we will get money. If we do this, we will get happiness. So these are all the lokatantra. Right? And we follow it. Anuvidhanam, anuvidhanam, anukaranam. So, lokatantra anuvidhanam anadritam yena. Durvasa ignores all these traditions that are the things that are followed in the world. Why? Because avapta samasta kamataya, all his desires have been fulfilled. So kinchidapi anadrata lokatantra anuvidhanam. Okay. Next is he gives two set of virodhabhasa alankara here. Read that. Just the next two you can read.
त्रिलोचनावतारम् अपि अप्य त्रिलोचनावतार सोदरम् अनसूया गर्भसंभवम् अत्यन्तकोपनम्
सो हि सेस् त्रिलोचन अवतारमपि अत्रिलोचन अवतार सोदरम् अनसूया गर्भसंभवम् अपि Atyanta Kopanam. These two are Virodha Alankara. We did this before. I told you how the Virodha Alankara acts and how we have to do the Virodha Pariharam for it. Right? So, Trilochana Avataram Api. Durvasa is the avatara of Shiva, Trilochana, the one who has three eyes. So, Trilochana Avataram is actually, I think Shiva was very angry at one point and his Kopam, nobody could take that. And that Kopa was deposited in Anasuya. And that Kopam is Durvasa, was born in the form of Durvasa. So he is the avatara of Shiva's anger. That's why he's probably so angry always. Right? So Trilochana avataram api, he is the avatara of Shiva. At the same time, Trilochana avatara sodaraha yaha na at Trilochana avatara. So on apparently, if you are Shiva's son, then you should be the sibling of Shiva's son also, right? So Trilochana avatara, another avatara of Shiva, Sodara is sibling. So if, for example, if you say that Pulyar, the Ganesha is not the Sodara or is not the sibling of Kartikeya, can we accept that? Then that is Virodham, right? If you are the son of the same person, then you have to be the sibling of this another son too. Whereas so here you'll have to split it in such a way that it makes sense. The Virodha Parihara. So Trilochana Avataram Api, a Trilochana Avatara Sodharam. He is not the sibling of the Avatara of Shiva. So how do you change that? Atri Lochana Avatara Sodharam. Atri Lochanat Yaha Avatarati. That is Chandra. Chandra was born from Atri Muni's eyes. This there is a story, Purana story for this, where I think Anasuya helped Kaushika or Kaushika's some curse and brought Kaushika back to life. So Brahma was so pleased, and he gave his power to Atri, and from Atri's eyes Chandra was born. After this Durvasa's shapa, Chandra along with Lakshmi and all the wealth went into the Samudra. Okay, so till then the birth of Chandra is talked of as Atri Suta or Atri Muni's, he was born out of Atri Muni's eye. So Atri Lochana Avatara, since Durvasa, Anasuya is Durvasa, Atri's wife. So he is Atri's son. Durvasa is Atri's son. So Atri Lochana Avatara Chandraha. Chandrasi Sodaraha Yaha Durvasaha. Okay. The next Virodhabhasa is Anasuya Garbha Sambhavamapi Atyanta Kopanam. So the first meaning that you have to take is Anasuya is Asuya Rahitaha Anasuyaha. One who is greedy will always be angry. That is a rule. So the thing is, you have a desire. If that desire is not fulfilled, you feel greedy, you want that desire. That is when, if you are not able to get it, you have a krodham, anger. Right? So, asuya garbham eva krodha. Yeah? So, asuya, anasuya garbha sambhavam api. Even though he was born without jealousy, atyanta kopanam, he has a great anger. Now, that is a virodha here. Because where there is jealousy, there should be anger. There is no jealousy here, but there is anger. He says, so to solve that virodha, we say Anasuya is Atri Patni. So Anasuya Garbha Sambhavam api, being born out of Anasuya, he is extremely angry. So there, when you do the Virodha Pariharam, you never use the word api there. That api is only used when you are explaining the Virodha that is there. When you Virodha Pariharam is done, and you talk of how both the adjectives fit Durvasa, you don't use api there. Okay? Do you get this?
So then how should we read it? Should we read Anasuya Garbha Sambhavam Atyanta Kopanam?
Yes. So when you eat, the beauty is apparent, there is an apparent contradiction there. You have to use api there. Okay? But when you explain it, you have to just use the two adjectives. That's all.
Oh.
Yes, in the Virodha, and then you do the Pariharam.
So the text has api, but in the meaning, we should not take api into the...
You don't need to. If you are explaining the Virodha, you have to use the api.
Oh.
See, Anasuya Garbha Sambhavam api Atyanta Kopanam. It will be better if you use it here. Trilochana Avataram api Atrilochana Avatara Sodaram. So even if he is Trilochana Avatara, he is not a Sodara of Trilochana Avatara. How can that be? That is a Virodha.
Hmm.
That even though is explained by that api. Right?
Hmm.
Now, and then you do the Virodha Pariharam and say, no, Atrilochana Avatara Sodaram is Atrilochana Avatara Sodara. That is how you split the word and use it. Hmm. When you say Trilochana Avataram, and Atrilochana Avatara Sodaram. So there are two steps involved in Virodhabhasa always. So the first is you use the api and explain how there is a Virodha, there is an apparent contradiction. And it is only apparent because you can explain the one of those in a different manner. Okay. Next.
Atikanthita. अति कठिनता कठिनता
तपो
कठिन कठिन तपो विशेष परिताशित परिताशित गौरी गौरी प्रसाद समासादि समासादितामपि कयापि विद्याधर कन्यया प्रार्थना मात्रादेव शापभीतया प्रणिपत्य समर्पितां कामपि कनकारविन्द अम्लान मालिकां आनयन्तं आपतन्तमग्रत एव निर्गलमभिमन्त्र्य मुक्ता मुक्ता भवव मुक्तार मव
मुक्तम इव
ओ मुक्तम इव मुक्तम इव पाशुपतम शरमनित लंघ लंघनीय तेजसम दुर्वाससम नाम तापस तापस समद्राक्षित
अद्राक्षित दुर्वाससम नाम तापसम अद्राक्षित Gachaneva Nabasi. So we have to connect with that. So Nabasi Gachaneva, as he was going in the Akasha, in the sky, Tapasam, Durvasasam Nama, Tapasam Adrakshit. He saw this sage named Durvasa. Now, everything was an adjective. All those second case, Dvitiya Vibhakti words were all an adjective to Durvasasam Nama Tapasam. Now, what are the rest of the adjectives that we have to see? Adi kathina tapo vishesha. Amlana malikam anayantam. Malikam anayantam. He brought a garland. How was that garland? Amlana. Unfading. Mlayati is fading. Amlana is that which does not fade. A garland which does not at all fade. Why? Because it is made of golden flowers. Kanaka aravindamayim. Made of golden lotuses. Kamapi kanaka aravindamayim amlana malika. It was some beautiful gold lotus garland which did not even fade. He brought that garland. Now, who gave it? Kaya api vidyadhara kanyaya pranipatya samarpitam. some Vidyadhara stri, Vidyadhari, gave it to him, samarpitam. This mala was given to him by some Vidyadhara stri. How did she get it? She got it by Ati Kathina Tapo Vishesha. She did a lot of tapas, Ati Kathina, very fearsome or tough penance. She made, did a tough penance. And then Paritoshita, she made Gauri happy. And then Gauri Prasada Samasaditam. She got it as a Gauri Prasada. Gauri Prasada Rupena Praptam Malika. Samasaditam api, even though she got that mala as a you know, present from Gauri by doing great penance, even then she gave it to this sage. Why? Shapa Bhitya. Prarthana Matra Deva. The moment Durvasa looked at that garland and he just asked, he did not you know, threaten her. We saw last time, no? The, where is that? Trasayantamiva Katarana, Bhartsayantamiva, Tarjayantamiva. He did not even have to threaten. The moment he just asked for it, Prarthana Matra Deva, by a mere request, Shapabhitya, Shapabhitaya, as if she was afraid of getting a curse, this Vidyadhara Stri, even though she got it by doing a great penance to Gauri, she gave that kamapi kanaka aravindamayim amlana malikam anayantam. She gave it samar pranipatya samarpitam. Sorry, pranipatya, she did the namaskara and gave that mala to Durvasa, and Durvasa brought that mala. Apatantam agrataha eva apatantam. Now, how did he look? What is the next one? Is this, it was as if, you know, Shiva's arrow was sent with a mantra. It is as if he was like a personification of Shiva's astra. That was how he looked at. He looked like. So agrata eva apatantam. Agrataha eva, in front of him itself, apatantam, the stage was coming. How was he? He was looking like nirargalam abhimantriya muktam pashupatam sharam iva. Nirargalam, argala is you know, that stopper that you put for the door, tapad. Nirargalam means the without any lock, without any lock. So here you take it as uncontrollable. He was like a Pashupata Shara, Shiva's arrow, which was sent muktam abhimantriya after saying a mantra. So any arrow is only a shastram, is only a weapon. It becomes an astra, it becomes it takes the nomenclature or the samya of astra when it is mantra purvaka. When you say a mantra and then drop the shastram or the weapon, it is called an astra. So weapons are only those, you know, the sword and arrow, bow, all those different weapons. But astram, anything can become an astra. You can, that's why in Ramayana, Rama just picks up one grass, says a mantra and throws it on Jayanta, Kakasura, right? So anything can become an astra. So he looked like as if he was like Shiva's arrow, which has been turned into an astra, abhimantriya muktam, and released. He looked as if he was an uncontrollable astra, nirargalam, agratayeva apatantam, which was coming directly towards him. Right? See, these are all indications that something bad is going to happen. So he should have known it. Indra being Indra and in such a position, he should have understood it, right? But that's why he says bhavitavyataya. The bhavitavyam or the fate is such that it can affect anybody. You don't know how it is going to affect, right? Even though he knew jananapi, he starts off the next paragraph by saying that. So apatantam agrata eva, in front of him itself, apatantam, who was coming. How was he? He was looking like Pashupatastra. Anatilanghaniya tejasam, one whose tejas or prakasha should not be overcome. Anatilanghaniya, it cannot be crossed, right? You cannot cross his path. That's what and nobody can overcome his tejas. That Durvasa Tapasam Adrakshita. Indra saw that sage.
Janan napi tamanati kramaniya tejasam durvasasam janan api jagadeva nikhila nikhilam apalita apalapita lapitu mantha manya manya
anyathaitum
anyathaitum cha naipunyam brahmanasya janannapi munikula mulikulanyakarana parinatam gatim nahushasya shishyopi brihaspatehe shilita mamarpi marmapi shilita marmapi dharma shastreshu.
We'll stop with that. Jananapi tam anatikramaniya tejasam durvasasam. Now Indra knew what sort of a person Durvasa was, right? Jananapi anatikramaniya tejas, anatikramaniya, one who should not be overcome or you should not cross his path, because he has such a great power and that power should not be crossed. He knows that Durvasa is such a person even then. Right, that's why he gives this Purupitika. So Jananapi Jagadeva Nikhila. Now first Durvasa's power he knows. Next, any Brahmin, Brahmanasya Naipunyam, he knows the expertise of a Brahmin to Nikhilam Jagadeva Apalapitam. A Brahmin is very capable of destroying the entire world. That also Indra knows. Right? Nikhilam Jagadeva Apalapitum Apalapitum. To destroy, nashayitum, anyathayitum. Anyathayitum is to change the world, change the appearance of the world or change the things that are there in the world. They have the capability of either completely destroying it or changing it into whatever he wants. That sort of an expertise is there with any Brahmin. Brahmanaha ityukte brahmani sthitaha brahmanaha, not a jatya brahmanaha. A person who has that power is only talking about that sort of a Brahman, right? So naipunyam brahmanasya naipunyam katham jagat akhilameva jagat apalapitum anyatha kartumva iti janannapi iti jnatva, even though he knew that. Next, munikula nyakkara parinatam gatim nahushasya cha janannapi, even though he knew the fate of Nahusha. Nahusha is a king who became a sarpa. He was going. Nahusha got the Indra Padavi after doing 100 yagas, and because he got the status of an Indra, he became very arrogant. And when he was going in the, I think, Pallak or something like that, when he was going there, Agastya. No, Durvasa, sorry. Durvasa was the person he asked to be one of the palanquin bearers. So when Durvasa was, or Agastya was shot, I think it's Agastya, right? Correct. Agastya's height was very short, so there was an imbalance in the palanquin. And Nahusha got very angry, so he said, sarpa, sarpa. Sarpati is gacha, gacha. So instead of using the word gacha, he used sarpa. And Agastya immediately cursed him by saying sarpo bhava. And he became a snake. And snakes are supposed to be in the Patalam. So right from Swarga, he didn't come to Bhulokam. He went directly to Patala, to the Sarpalokam. So Munikula Nyakkara. Nyakkara is insulting the Munikula, the sages. What is the result of that? Nahusha's gati. So Nahusha got that gati or the state because of insulting the sages. Now, even though he knew about all of this, he still did that. Right? Indra, even though he knew that he should not, he knew Durvasa's anger, power, he knew the expertise or the capabilities of a Brahmin, and he also knew the result of insulting a sage, right? Shishyopi Brihaspatehe. He is the student. Indra is the student of Brihaspati. Brihaspati is the most intelligent person in the world, and he is Brihaspati's student. what is because of that what has he done dharma shastreshu shilita marma api dharma shastra he knows what is dharma and the different dharma shastras he has analyzed the in depth marma is rahasyam shilita marma he has analyzed the rahasyas that are there in the dharma shastra even though he has done all that paricharya ratah api nisargata eva brahmanam brahmananam brahmananam ब्राह्मणानां परिचर्या रतः अपि निसर्गत एव बै नेचुरल अकरेन्स ही नेचुरलि डस् सेवा टु ब्राह्मिन्स् दट् इस् हिस् द पुरन्द गुणोम्ब यु आर् बोर्न् वित् दट् क्वालिटि दट् इस् निसर्गत एव ब्राह्मणानां परिचर्या रतः इस् कान्स्टेण्ट्लि इन्वाल्व्ड् इन् डूयिङ्ग् सर्विस् परिचर्या टु ब्राह्मणानां टु ब्राह्मिन्स् The next one.
Chaturananada cha kitapatangebhyah tulyavadeva prabhavantya bhagavatya bhavitavyataya vilasena tribhuvanadhi tribhuvanadhipatya madandhikrita लोचनो धीमानपि सहस्रलोचनो न तं प्रत्यवरुरोह न तरामुपचचार गिरा न तमां च प्रणनाम
Now, Paricharya Rato Api Nisargata Eva Brahmananam. Even though, despite the fact that he knew what will be the effect of everything, Even though he knows the Dharma Shastra, he is Brihaspati's Shishya. See, just because you are some great Guru's Shishya, it doesn't mean that you have to use your own intelligence, right? So you can just repeat whatever the teacher says. That is one thing. The next step is analyzing, right? You have to analyze everything and use your own intelligence also. Not only that is Acharya Padam Adatte, Padam Shishya Swamedaya. So both are present in him. Padam సబ్రహ్మచారిభ్యః పాదం కాలక్రమేణ చ రైట్ దెన్ ద ఫోర్త్ హాఫ్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ ఇంటెలిజెన్స్ విల్ కమ్ ఓన్లీ డ్యూ టు ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ నౌ హియర్ హీ టాక్స్ అబౌట్ బోత్ ద ఫస్ట్ అండ్ ద సెకండ్ హీ హ్యాస్ ది నాలెడ్జ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద గురు బృహస్పతే శిష్యః అండ్ హీ ఆల్సో హ్యాస్ ది అనలైజింగ్ కేపబిలిటీస్ సో ధర్మశాస్త్రేషు శీలిత మర్మ అపి నెక్స్ట్ పరిచర్యా రథః హీ ఈజ్ By nature, a humble person and does seva to Brahmana. Everything is there. Yet, what is the problem here? A chaturananath, a cha kita patangebhyah. A is from Brahma to kita patanga, to the worm, and patanga is moth. Worms are those which are there in the bhumi, and patanga represents everything that flies. So he is talking about every small... Patanga is the smallest of the flying things and Kita is the smallest of the terrestrial things, right? A worm. So from Brahma, Chaturmukha Brahma, Chaturananath, A Kita Patangebhyah, until the smallest of beings in the world, nobody can escape fate. Tulyavadeva Prabhavantya. Fate will proceed in a manner that is equal. She is not at all partial. So Bhagavati Bhavitavyata. Bhavitavyata, that which has to happen, that is fate, Niyatihi. Tulyavadeva Prabhavantya. She has an effect on everybody in the similar manner. Niti Shatakam, he says, his way of expression itself is very beautiful. Bhartrihari has a very unique way of saying the same thing he says. Brahmayena Kulalavati. Niyamitaha Brahmanda Bandodare. Brahma is after all just a potter, you know, a potter who keeps on churning out pots. In the same way, this entire world is like the chakram from which the pots keep coming out. This world is the chakram, and from there, Brahma keeps on creating like the potter. Brahma yena, by whom Brahma has been pushed into the work of a potter. So, Chaturananath, he also adds Vishnu, Vishnuryena, Dashavatara, Gahane, Kshipto, Mahasankate. Vishnu has been pushed into this great trouble, Mahasankatam, of this forest. You know, this forest is Dasha Avatara. He has to keep on doing this 10 avataras, right? That is fate for him, even Vishnu. Rudro yena kapala bhikshatanam karitaha. Kapala pani putake bhikshatanam karitaha. Shiva is also constantly begging with the kapalam in his hand. Suryo brahmyati yena. This sun is also constantly being pushed and by someone. And who is that? Tasmai namah karmane. That karma or fate, vidhi, that acts, and because of that, each one, even the Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva and Surya, everybody is being pushed into that cycle. They cannot escape that fate. That's what he's saying. So, ah chaturananadu, ah kita patangebhya, even the smallest of beings in this world, tulyavadeva pravavantya, one whose effect is the same for everybody. Bhagavatyaha bhavitavyaha bhavitavyatayaha vilasena, because of her vilasa or her play. What happened? Indra tribhuvana adhipatya mada andhikrita lovachanaha. His eyes are andhikrita, blind, because of the arrogance that he has. Mada, where does that mada come from? Tribhuvana adhipatya, the sovereignty of the three worlds that he holds. He becomes very arrogant because of that, and his eyes are blind. Dhiman api sahasralochanaha. Even though he has that intelligence, dhiman, shilita marma api dharma shastreshu, right? Sahasralochanaha, not just two eyes, but he has thousands of eyes to look at everything and understand things. Even then, natam prati avaruroha. He did not get down, avaruroha, avarohati. He did not get down towards the sage. So the first thing is, when you see the sage walking down and you are on an elephant, you have to immediately get down. So first, he did not get down. Okay, if you don't get down, you should at least say, ah, vango, come, welcome. Something or the other you have to say, right? Na taram upachachara gira. Gira, with his words, na upachachara, he did not do a service, or upacharam, he did not do a seva with at least words. He should have said, come. That taram and tamam that he uses the next step. So I'll come to that again. So na tamam prananama, or he should have at least bowed his head and said his pranams, right? That also he did not do. Nacha prananama. So first, he did not get down. Let alone get down, he could have at least said welcome. Na gira upachachara. Or he should, even if he doesn't open his mouth, he could have at least, you know, acknowledged. That also he did not do. Na tama. Now, this tara and tama are actually suffixes that you use for saying super, comparative and superlative, right? So, madhuraha, madhurataraha, madhuratamaha. It is an adjective form, so you can use it as tamam, taram, and tara, tama, and all that. Now, this taram and tamam used here is an avyaya, which is used with the verb to intensify the verb, to show the comparative and superlative nature of the verb. So when you say taram upachachara, taram prananama, he did not, na taram, it should be negative. Either negative or positive also. If I say taram upachachara gira, he used the words to offer service in a very great manner. It intensifies the action of the word. It is not just upachachara, but adhikataram upachachara ityartha. Or adhikatamam na prananama, or adhikatamam pranamama. Adhikatamam prananama. It depends on whether he has used the negative or not. Okay? It is not strilinga, it is avyaya.
Avyaya. So it is tara and tama.
Yeah. Say am is added to tarap. Am is added to tarap, and it is like an adverb. That is, it is like a kriya visheshana.
So it is not taram because it is tam in the previous word. So it is
no.
So
If it is tam in the, if it is like tam in the previous thing, then it should be taram and tamam, right? It is not because of that. So here, taram, tarap is the suffix. Okay. So tara and am is added to it and made it as a kriya visheshanam, and it is an adjective to the upachachara.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it is not an adjective to Durvasa or Indra or anybody, but it is an adjective to the verb. Okay, and so you can't say it is in Strilinga. It is like Kriya Visheshanam is more of a Avyaya. It is an indeclinable. It has no status as such as a Lingam or, you know, like Sukham Aswapsam. I slept very happily. What is that Sukham? Sukham is not Napunsakalinga or anything. It's more of an Avyaya.
So with that, any verb, it is going to be Taram and Tamam.
Yes. It lacked as a Kriya Visheshan. Okay. Apicha.
Na kevalam tamavajadnye apitu punarasambha punaha asambhavani asambhavitenapi tena vitirya mana madaya savagnya mekena panina malikam pashyat eva maharshehe anupaniya mukuta tatim anaghraya chantataha skandha eva sindhurasya niveshayamasa.
Apicha na kevalam tam avajagnye. He not only ignored him. Avajagnye, avajanati is ignoring. He not only ignored him. Apitu punaha asambhavitena apitena vitiryamanam malikam adaya. He not only ignored him, he also did not consider the malika that he gave, the garland that Durvasa gave. Now, asambhavitena tena Durvasa sa asambhavitaha, he was not asevitaha. He was not without even being served properly, right? Or honored. Without being honored, Durvasa, despite that, he gave the mala. See, Durvasa's nature is to curse immediately the moment he is ignored. But here, even though Indra ignored him, he still gave that mala to Indra. So asambhavitena api tena durvasasa vitiryamanam dattam malikam savagnyam adaya. Here also that is a visheshanam, kriya visheshanam. See, he takes it with by ignoring it, you know. Savagnyam adaya, he took the garland ekena panina. When you take a prasada, you take with both hands. But what did he do here? Ekena panina, with just one hand, he takes that malikam adaya pashyata eva maharshehe. When that maharshi, that sage, was looking, as he was looking, anupaniya makutatatim, this pashyata eva maharshehe is anadritya, maharshim anadritya, shashti cha anadhare, you know, saptami, sati saptami, right? So pashyan pashyati sati, maharshau pashyati sati, when the sage is looking, whereas here, at the same time, when you put it in sixth case, it means Indra does not even consider the fact that sage is looking at him. As that sage was looking, he ignored him. That is what it means when you use Shashti Vibhakti instead of Saptami in Sapti Saptami. So as the sage was looking, he ignored him. Anupaniya Makuta Tatim. Makuta Tatim, the forehead. Forehead is the place where the Makuta is kept. So Makuta Tatim, forehead, Anupaniya, without even taking it to his forehead. So the moment you take a prasada, you keep it on your forehead, right? So that also he did not do. Anagraya, let alone giving it respect. You should at least acknowledge the presence of that mala by at least smelling it, right? Someone gives you a flower, the moment you take that flower, you want to smell it. Even that he did not know. Anagraya, even without smelling it. Antataha, at the end, what did he do? Sindhurasya skandhe eva. Niveshayamasa, he placed it. He placed it on the skandhe, on the shoulder of the elephant Sinduraha. Niveshita matracha, as soon as he kept it there, sa mala nisarga niravagrahena vetandena. Vetandaha is also Sinduraha gajaha. Nisarga niravagrahena, by nature, it is very difficult to control that elephant. So niravagraha, avagraha is control, niravagraha is uncontrollable. Nisarga niravagraha, by nature, it is uncontrollable elephant. So what did that elephant do? Shundaya, with its trunk, akrishya, that sa akrishya, that mala, the garland was pulled by that elephant, and nishpipishe, it was crushed. So the elephant took that mala. It is in passive voice here. So sa mala nishpipishe, it was crushed by Vetandena, by the elephant, with its shunda.
Atra tamavajagne, tam avajagne. In what lakara is it?
That is lit lakara.
Lit.
The lit lakara, atmanepadi.
Lit lakara, va?
Lit.
Lit lakara atmanepadi.
Oh. Yeah. So avajanati, avajanite, avajagni.
Oh. Okay. Sinduraha itite, airavataha eva.
Sinduraha, any elephant, gajaha. So sinduraha, any elephant. It's not only airavata. Here sinduraha, gajaha, vetandaha is also gajaha. It is not specific to airavata. Sindhura is actually a great elephant. It is one of the jati elephants. Okay, we'll stop with this, and the next is shlokas. We'll see it next class. Okay. Namaste.
Dhanyavaad. Namaste.